to turn that off.
Thank you.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed.
Alleluia.
Good morning, welcome back to church, even if it's from a distance. It's good to be back in this space. The Paschal candles are lit on Easter night, and on that night day I brought the flame into the sanctuary, so the sanctuary lamp has been alight since then. But having come back into the church space, I now want to light the Paschal candle and from it light the candles on the altar. It's easier said than done, this. So we say the Gloria together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. We come before God in prayer and praise, and in the quiet we wait on God's Holy Spirit. Merciful God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as pass our understanding. Pour into our hearts such love toward you, that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises, which exceed all that we can desire. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. First reading is taken from the book of Acts, chapter 17. Then Paul stood in front of the Areopagus and said, Athenians, I see how extremely religious you are in every way. For as I went through the city and looked carefully at the objects of your worship, I found among them an altar with the inscription, To an unknown God. What therefore you worship as unknown, this I proclaim to you. The God who made the world and everything in it, he who is Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in shrines made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands as though he needed anything, since he himself gives to all mortals life and breath and all things. From one ancestor, he made all nations to inhabit the whole earth, and he allotted the times of their existence and the boundaries of the places where they would live, so that they would search for God and perhaps grope for him and find him, though indeed he is not far from each one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being. And as even some of your own poets have said, for we too are his offspring. Since we are God's offspring, we ought not to think that the deity is like gold or silver or stone, an image formed by the art and imagination of mortals. While God has overlooked the times of human ignorance, he now commands all people everywhere to repent, for he has fixed a day on which he will judge the world in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed, and of this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead. The response to the psalm is, "Let the sound of his praise be heard."
Let the sound of his praise be heard.
Bless our God, you peoples. Make the voice of his praise to be heard, who holds our souls in life and will not allow our feet to slip. Let the sound of his praise be heard. For you, O God, have proved us. You have tried us as silver is tried. You brought us into the snare. You laid heavy burdens upon our backs. You let enemies ride over our heads. We went through fire and water, but you brought us out into a place of refreshment. Let the sound of his praise be heard. I will enter your house with burnt offerings and will pay my vows, which I promised with my lips and spoke with my mouth when I was in trouble. I will offer you sacrifices of fat beasts with the smoke of rams. I will give you oxen and goats. Let the sound of his praise be heard. Come and listen, all you who fear God, and I will tell you what he has done for me. I called out to him with my mouth, and his praise was on my tongue. If I had found evil in my heart, the Lord would not have heard me. Let the sound of his praise be heard. But in truth, God has heard me. He has attended to the voice of my prayer. Blessed be God, for he has not rejected my prayer, nor withheld his love from me. Let the sound of his praise be heard. The second reading is taken from the first epistle of Peter. Who will harm you if you are eager to do what is good? But even if you do suffer for doing what is right, you are blessed. Do not fear what they fear, and do not be intimidated. But in your hearts sanctify Christ as Lord. Always be ready to make your defence to anyone who demands from you an account of the hope that is in you. Yet do it with gentleness and reverence. Keep your conscience clear, so that when you are maligned, those who abuse you for your good conduct in Christ may be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if suffering should be God's will, than to suffer for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, in order to bring you to God. He was put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit, in which he also went and made a proclamation to the spirits in prison, who in former times did not obey, but when God waited patiently in the days of Noah, during the building of the ark, in which a few, that is, eight persons, were saved through water. And baptism, which this prefigured, now saves you, not as a removal of dirt from the body, but as an appeal to God for a good conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers made subject to him. We now turn to sing, and we're going to sing hymn number 13, All for Jesus. Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. On that day you will know that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I in you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me, and those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Brothers and sisters, I ask you to profess the faith of the Church. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen.
In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to God our Father. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are the one who has created us in your image. You are the one who has created all things and put boundaries in their place so that people may search after you. Pray for the world in which we live. And even in these times, we give thanks for its beauty. We give thanks for the sunshine, for the plants around us, and the animals we see. And we thank you that you have given us a place with them in your creation. And so we ask that you would help us to work together for its good. We ask that you would help us to learn from our present experience, to honour your gifts to us, and to be grateful. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Remembering Paul's speech at the Areopagus, we pray for the Church in our day. Help us to faithfully proclaim an unknown and unseen God to people who do not know Christ. Help us to be reverent and humble, and help us to see our own faults, that we might better rely upon your grace and honour you for your mercy. Help us this day to see Christ and to know his life in us as we remember the resurrection this day. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give thanks for the love and service of those around us, remembering especially key workers. We continue to pray for those who work in hospital, doctors and nurses, and those who support the life of the hospital. We remember Julia, priest in his parish. We also pray for those who work on transport, for those who teach in our schools, for all who supply the infrastructure we rely on. Bless them, Lord, we pray. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, as you remember that you are in the Father, and that you are in us, we pray for those with needs at this time. We remember by name Charlene and Jackie. And we remember all those known to us who are in need. Lord, strengthen them in their faith and resolve. Remind them that you are not far from them, and help us to be close to them in their need as well. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So as you remember that on the third day he rose again from the dead, we pray for those who have died in the faith of Christ, and those whose faith is known to you alone. Pray for Pam Goff, whose funeral is on Monday morning, for Joan Leslie Dern, Michael Shrewsbury, and William Kearns. And remember those whose anniversary of death occurs at this time: Charles Miller, Doris Brooks and William Elliott, Cyril McCartney, John Martin, and Joy Lewis. Grant us with them a share in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And so finally, we pray for ourselves. Lord, stir up in our hearts love for you, that that love might overflow, and that we may obey your commandments and be witnesses to all. Name to you any particular needs we have at this time in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. So we come to the peace. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. The peace of the risen Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
I invite you to offer those around you and those in your hearts a sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal Father, and in these days of Easter to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mysteries of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed us once more in paradise and opened to us the gate of life eternal. And so in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and all the powers of creation sing forever the hymn of your glory. Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna
in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Praise to you, Lord Jesus. Dying you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, Mother of God, the Holy Apostles, St. Lawrence, St. Stephen, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Rejoicing in God's new creation, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us. Alleluia, let us keep the feast. Let us pray. God our Father, whose Son Jesus Christ gives the water of eternal life, may we thirst for you, the spring of life and source of goodness, through him who is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen. Together we say, Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a quick thank you to Dan for helping us set up this morning, and to Duncan for playing the organ, and to Angela for sorting out the altar in advance of coming into the space. And thank everyone for joining us as well this morning. So we're going to sing next. Number 12. Hallelujah, sing to Jesus.
In the name of Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.